Hey everybody, this is Dr. Andy. Today we are joined by Daniel from CrossFit Simplicity here in Burlington. Daniel, welcome. Thank you very much for joining us today.
Yeah, thank you for having me. Awesome. I'm excited to be here.
Yes, sir. Daniel, for those that don't know you, tell us a little bit about yourself and a little bit about your business.
Yeah, definitely. So I own CrossFit Simplicity. We're kind of in the downtown Burlington area. So a lot of people know the Blend, Burlington Beer Works, the police department, about a half mile from that. So we're kind of central in here. And I'm 31 years old, Burlington, North Carolina. I'm a native here. I did go to school in Chapel Hill for a little while. Did my undergrad, came back. This is actually my second gym. I was training at a gym. A lot of people, if you've been in the area for a while, know CrossFit Training Valley. I was training there for a little while. Actually ended up with a partner buying that gym and ran it for about 2 years, and then ended up selling out to him. And then this is pretty interesting, actually, kind of timely. Almost 4 years ago, so February 2017, opened up CrossFit Simplicity. So this February will be our 4 year. Yeah, kind of.
Congratulations.
4 years. Yeah, thank you. Yeah, not that 4 years is necessarily a bit. Maybe five is maybe a big milestone.
It is. For people that don't know it, if you're in small business or like that, there's like little. Sadly, the statistics of how well small businesses do, it's a pretty bad statistic. And one of the big ones is like 5 years. If you can survive 5 years, like it's kind of a big deal, actually. It's kind of scary.
Oh, yeah. 5, 10, I feel like. Yep. We've been really blessed. We have a ton of help. I'm married. I have 4 little girls, which is kind of wild. I just had one, Eleanor, in September.
That's right.
So she's
right.
Like
again,
4 or 5 months old. So
yeah.
We're wide open, but we have had great help. We've got 4 or 5 coaches now that help us out. And so I think that's been like a big part of it as well. And just community kind of generation. So it's been great. So even through COVID and all that stuff, we've actually been super blessed.
Good.
So it looks like I don't want to knock on wood.
Right.
You know, we'll go to 5, we'll go to 10, and I think we should be good to go. So we got no plans of going anywhere anytime soon. But this is CrossFit Simplicity. Like I said, this is the second kind of location. Sold out of Training Valley. Was not really sure exactly which direction I wanted to go, but I knew that I wanted to be in this space. I knew I wanted to do CrossFit. This is kind of to digress a little bit, but and my family knows to a fault, of course, and I'm sure it's caused problems in the past, but right, I always kind of joke and say, nobody cares more about their health and wellness and fitness than me, you know, about my own personal one. So CrossFit's a super easy sell for me, because I do it myself every day.
Yep,
so
yep.
I'm telling, you know, hey, if I'm going to spend 1 hour, 2 hours a day, you know, I'm going to do whatever I think is going to get me in the best shape for what I'm looking to do. So for me,
it will. I mean, like if you do CrossFit or if you know much about it, like if you do it, like, you know, after that hour that you're done, like if I can do that, I can take on about anything.
Oh yeah. You're good to go. So I knew I kind of wanted to be in the space. I knew I was really passionate about it and stuff. And so, we're so blessed. The right doors just kind of opened.
Good.
Even space. Honestly, we were looking.
I love your space.
Yeah, thank you. We got about 5,000 square foot here. We're always, I know my landlord was in here the other day and we were just like chatting, of course. But I'm always like kind of looking and thinking like, can we use some more space or something?
Yep.
So I don't know. Like I said, look in the future, maybe next couple years, you know, maybe expand, get a little bit bigger. But right now, it's perfect. We got 5,000 square foot. We have a main platform where all of our classes kind of take place. And then we actually about 2 years ago added about another 2,500 square foot of just rubber, or 1,500 square foot of rubber to kind of complement the other platform, which is about 2,500. And so that's kind of where open gym will happen. So we have athletes that will come in, they'll hit their class at like 4:30, let's say, or 5:30, 12 o'clock, and then they'll stay afterwards, right, can use the space, or even during a class, right, we might have somebody comes in and wants to do their own thing. And so that's been really good. But this was a great place for us. It was nice to kind of get a fresh start.
Yeah.
Took over Training Valley. Mm-hmm. And so we made a lot of changes and I think things were great. Love the gym. Always kind of have I got an old, pointing to my fridge, I got an old CrossFit Training Valley sticker on my fridge. And people are like, oh, you got like, which it's out of business now, but is that a competitor? I'm like, hey, that's your roots.
No, that's the roots. You know? Right.
So you do CrossFit and stuff in Burlington. So, you know, it's like, you know, in a community like this, we all kind of spawn out of the same thing.
I was going to say that. Like, if you have a conversation with Tyler Smiley, who I know that you also know, right? I mean, he says it's like every gym in Alamance County has sort of like spawned off, and it all kind of comes from, like, I feel like even I get patients in here all of the time who haven't been to 584 or Simplicity, but they'll talk about their days at Training Valley.
That's wild. And we send a lot of people your way. That's
you
right.
do.
That's
you awesome. Do. So first and foremost, thank you.
Because really, and this is crazy, I was going to Raleigh, and before you came around, I feel like there wasn't somebody like in this area that also had like a sports mindset too. Yep. Because, you know, it's really, it's so frustrating to go somewhere and somebody say, you know, and just not really understand what you're doing, I guess, you know, and don't really know, like, because I can ask you, you know, honestly, like, well, look, like, is rest really going to help this, or do I just need to scale things back? Or do I need to, like, not go overhead for the next week? Or, you know what I mean? Whereas, you know, if you go to somebody who just doesn't have that kind of background, or they just don't care about that kind of, like, patient.
Or just don't care.
You just don't know, like, gosh, what am I getting? Like, I don't know, you know? So it's nice to be able to be like, hey, go over here and, you know, they do CrossFit. they know. Or they work, you know, functional fitness, let's just say.
There you go. Yeah. I think the problem a lot of times with, like, modern American healthcare is that it's tried to be a little too cookie cutter, right? And so no one takes the time to understand the mind of a CrossFitter. So if this is, you know, a generic medical clinic or a generic chiropractic clinic, and you come in and you're a CrossFitter expecting, you know, how can I get some help from this person? But that provider, whether it's a chiropractor, a medical doctor, or anyone, just says like, hey, you know, I'm going to need you to stop working out for a month. Right. That's not going to work. You can't tell a CrossFitter that, right? Or someone who's like super into fitness or functional fitness. That's not what they want to hear. So they'll just either ignore everything you say, or they'll go find someone who will tell them what they want to hear. Right. Yeah. So if you give them options in terms of like, well, maybe this one movement is actually kind of the generating cause of your discomfort and your pain, and it's causing all the inflammation, maybe avoid that one movement, but you're still strong, right?
Yeah.
You're still capable to do 95%, you know, percent of all of the other movements. Go do that. It's okay to load it.
It's so cliche, but, and again, it sounds like such a selling point, but it's like nothing's worse for you than doing nothing.
Yes.
You
correct.
Know, and so
correct,
it's like, correct, oh correct. Gosh, what are you going to do? Go sit on the couch. And this is kind of a crazy side note as well, but I had, and again, it sounds terrible, but super honest. It probably might've come from this. Everybody's different. We've had people and we are so blessed. First off, I mean, everybody gets, if you're doing anything, and you know, sports medicine, injury rates and stuff, you know, running is one of the most dangerous things you can do, but I'm not going to knock running. It's just, hey, sometimes you twist your ankle or you get a shin splint. Mm-hmm. Same thing in here. You know, people get up, they get moving, you know, there's going to be little aches and pains or tweaks here and there, but I can't tell you the amount of people that we have that say, like, since I started coming here and really just getting stronger, right? It could be anywhere, but just like, since I started moving, since I started doing functional movement, my back pain's gone down, my knee pain's gone down, I no longer have this stuff. And I was getting it. I've been living with a hernia for about a year and a half, maybe 2 years, an ingral hernia. Had actually gotten significantly worse. But again, I had talked to my doctors. They basically said, hey, look, you know, the discomfort, it's not killing you. As long as you can stand it, go ahead and, you know, work through it. And so I just been working through it, lifting heavy, not, you know, hadn't been stopping me at all, but some other circumstances came about and I said, hey, I think it's time to get it fixed. So I went ahead and got it fixed, but I was talking to my doctor and I mean, I made just an amazing recovery. They were giving me a hard time, family or gym members, don't do that. But I said, hey y'all, I'm not being super tough and pushing through pain. I'm just not having any pain. And my doctor said, hey, listen to your body. I'm not going to tell you how long you're going to be down. You're going to be great. But one thing that was interesting, and with, especially with the current, you know, health crisis and things going on, is I just had a great relationship with this guy. And I told him, I said, you know, hey, you know, thank you so much. Like, I really appreciate, you know, what you've done for me. And not a brag or anything, but he said, thank you. It's a real pleasure working on someone who, like, takes care of themselves. And I think they just see so many people who have just let themselves go to such an extreme. And then by the time they have to get that surgery or this, you know, they're so out of shape that, you know, so many complications arise. I think people think they have to do just some extreme stuff like the CrossFit games, when in reality, you just need to move, you know, for, you know, 30 or 40 minutes a day, you know, and just start those baby steps, you know, and get into doing something. And it just makes a huge difference, really.
That's exactly what I would say. It sounds like this doc is the exact same kind of person as me. It's like, I used to do a lot more general population, and it was just sometimes disappointing because people just were not invested in their own health. Yeah. And then once I discovered working a lot more with athletes and people that had a lot more goals for themselves personally, they kind of challenged me to be a better doctor. And it just, you know, that's where I found like my passion. And something you said earlier that just made perfect sense in terms of movement is medicine, right? You're going to hurt yourself no matter what. What I tell people in my office is you're going to cause wear and tear on your body in the gym or at home sitting and doing absolutely nothing. A sedentary lifestyle still causes wear and tear on your body. Which one do you want to cause, right? Yeah. Go with the one where you're using and abusing that body, picking up heavy things and putting them back down, because long-term that's healthier for you.
Oh yeah, absolutely. And this sounds, you mentioned something too, kind of invested, you know, that's one thing too, is that, and you see people from all over, but a lot of functional fitness people too. And even if it's not a CrossFit gym per se, those environments are a little bit more expensive. And so think about like, you know, it's New Year time-ish, you know, you can go to Planet Fitness, you know, down the road and $9.99, you're in, you know, in the door. And I'm sure there, you know, there may be, or you might have other, like, let's say competition, maybe cheaper or something, but that's a big thing to talk about too, is like, you know, taking care of yourself like that. And again, twofold. One, it is an investment up front. You know, our average membership is about $145 a month. You know, we have a couple little different things that we do, maybe some discounts for students or fire police. But in general, that's about our rate. But, you know, think about somebody that has that kind of skin in the game is really going to like show up and do that. And that's what you mentioned about athletes. Like they come in, they're so much more invested. It's like, so for me, when I need to get some work done and I come in there to you, it's like, I don't balk at, you know, spending money on that because I'm like, oh my gosh, that's an investment. I need to like take care of my body. I need to, you know, I need to maintain my physical health. I need to maintain my range of motion, be able to move, be able to be comfortable. So sometimes it's like rewarding, you know, working with people like that because, hey, they got a little skin in the game or they're in, you know, they're going to take your advice, you know, when you send them home, which makes a big difference.
Compare gyms to cars. Do you want the cheapest, most beat down car on the lot or do you want the Ferrari? Yeah, I know which car I want.
Yeah, it makes a difference. Ferrari. Yeah, there you go. We don't need to do that. It's more important to be healthy.
Right, yeah, there you go.
Than to afford the Ferrari.
So let's ask a question for people that don't understand, because I feel like CrossFit can get a bad rap sometimes. I think the reason is that it's so horribly misunderstood. Help us all understand what CrossFit is, what its strengths are.
Yeah, that's awesome. I mean, I'll give you like the twofold, like the fitness and then the CrossFit simplicity. Because sometimes I'll catch myself and I'll be emailing somebody back and I'll say CrossFit. Then I'll think and I'll change it. CrossFit simplicity. Because you know, like anything else, you know, and that's what's so great about CrossFit is it's had hiccups and stuff along the way and positive and negative.
2020 was a rough year.
Hey, for everybody. Yeah. Like anything else. But it's really nice because they do – let's use a Planet Fitness example. But not to plug a competitor necessarily, but I don't believe that's a competitor of ours, right? It's just so different.
Right.
But that's
going
to be pretty similar whether you visit one in Austin, Texas, or whether you visit one in Burlington, North Carolina. But you can visit two different CrossFit gyms in Burlington, North Carolina, or Greensboro, or Raleigh, and they're going to have their own, like, feel. So I think CrossFit, you know, I think main strengths of, like, CrossFit simplicity and us here, I think what's helped us so much and just been amazing, like, feedback is you know, just the vibe in the community. And that sounds like so cliche, but I'm sure you've experienced
it's cliche from the outside. It's cliche from the outside. Once you're part of it, you get it. And you're like, oh yeah, this is awesome.
Well, people get it. You could go to our Instagram page right now and look back at a review we posted from a young man, like one of our members. And I mean, it's just amazing the stuff he has to say. And he has some medical issues coming in. And then, but the number one thing was like, hey, I'm new to the area and I've just found a home. And so like, I think that's the biggest thing that keeps people coming back. And I've done so many things. I got dropped off at the Gold's Gym that's been burned down now, but it was a Gold's Gym on Alamance Road in Burlington on 62 years ago. I got dropped off there. I was 15 years old. Mom signed a waiver. I've been doing that stuff forever. I've done, you know, P90X. I've done it all. What I've really found is that whatever you do, and if you do it consistently, you're going to get results. Now, I believe that CrossFit's going to get you the best results and the best kind of results. But whatever you do, you're going to get results. And so I think as far as CrossFit simplicity, I think, and CrossFit in general too, I think, of course, it's like a fitness, you know, routine. But more than that, I think it's that it's found a way to incorporate that tribe mentality, right? And that small group of 75 to 150 people that all have this common collective goal. And so that's what keeps people coming back. Physically, it's really just a conglomeration of like movements and stuff. So you give you like the CrossFit HQ definition, but in reality, we're just mixing in a lot of functional movements. We're doing long, short, heavy, light, you know, we're doing like barbell and free weight stuff. We're doing gymnastic and like body weight stuff. And so I think the variance and stuff is what makes it so special from an athletic standpoint, because once you get into it, the possibilities are endless. The combination of time domains and modes that you can set up for a workout. And that's what keeps your body guessing and keeps, you know, the results coming in. But if you're not coming through the door, you're never going to get that. And so I think what's been so special for us, and even through COVID we saw, and especially coming back and all this stuff, is and this is a shameless plug, but if you go to our, just Google CrossFit Simplicity, you know, to learn more about us. But just, we have like 100, I saw it the other day, just like blew me away, because this, over the years, you'll notice it, 105 reviews. And if you just read them, you know, this much of it is about the results that people got. Not that they didn't, but, you know, 80% of it is just like the coaches, the people, everyone made me feel welcome. And I think that's the kind of stuff that you're going to get.
Because they can get results, like you're saying, anywhere, as long as they're motivated enough. But that's not what's going to get people excited. It's the experience that they have that gets people excited and will drive someone to leave a review.
Oh, yeah, for sure. And, you know, think about, we'll have people that could absolutely do this on their own. You know, take me, for example, where I train with a group of guys, you know, and one of our coaches around, you know, mid-morning every day. And any of us could just go off with a bar and stuff and do this stuff on our own. But every day we come together because nobody wants to like hit that alone. So it's that like community vibe mentality. And I think that's, it's amazing. And not to get too much into it, but just with the climate that's going on in the world today, the most amazing thing about CrossFit is, and I think CrossFit Simplicity, you know, specifically, is that like, it was such a melting pot of people and views and ideas, but the emphasis and the highlight is on what we share in common with each other and not differences. And so I always say, and this video could get taken down for this, but you know, Facebook is such a divisive place. Social media is such a divisive place because, you know, you would never sit next to somebody in a doctor's office or on the bus and just attack each other, get into so much stuff.
Yeah. But they feel free doing it on the internet, don't they?
We're able to do that. But here, I mean, you'll have just a total kaleidoscope of different views and opinions and backgrounds and religion and politics. And one, it never even comes up, which is like kind of nice. And two, it's just a place to bring people together. So it's just, that's what's been so special for me. I think the older I get, and that sounds cliche, like I said, I'm 31, I'm not that old, I hope.
30 years here, 30 years young.
Oh, the more I'll sit back and just kind of go like, wow, like this place is special. Not because when I was young, it was just slamming bars and working out, and, you know, drinking black coffee. And now it's like, you know, what drives me every day, and especially, is just like, just the people. I mean, it's just, I have to catch myself and say, hey, you're here to coach. You're not here to social hour.
I can get in trouble for that one myself. Yeah. See, that's where my passion's like, same thing. My passions are with the people. Right. And so I can feel your passion, and it strikes a note with me only because like I could get caught up. Like I could easily just install a coffee shop, like in my office and sit, and rather than treat the patient, I could just sit there and chat and like have a cup of coffee and talk about the world's problems like all day long, you know, solving them one by one. That would be the best.
It's huge. It really is. And I think that's what's so neat about it. So obviously the fitness, you know, aspect of it is awesome. And that's what, you know, drives results and stuff too. But I think, you know, getting people in the door and having that kind of feel, and people really do, you know, they know each other, they know each other's names, you know, before COVID, we were a lot better about it. Now as we're getting better at navigating things, we're starting back a little bit more, but, you know, we used to do a lot of community events and things like that, which got people together. And so, you know, it sounds funny, but you know, a lot of my, you know, relationships in life and friendships, you know, they're, and for a lot of people that are our gym members as well, it's like most of their friendships, relationships, right, are like out of the gym. You know, it's like this is our main hub for community. And I think that's so important right now. It's so good. We can come in here and safely do it. It is like just getting people, I mean, it's just just mental health. It's just huge for mental health. So it's I think it's so important. I think now more than ever, it's just taking care of yourself physically and mentally is just huge.
Speaking of taking care of yourself, then what would you say to the person who feels like, I can't do CrossFit, I need to get in shape first?
Because
the only thing they see are like, you know, the CrossFit games. Like, I'll tell people, like, listen, like, I might do
CrossFit. This ain't going to the CrossFit.
Yeah, like, yeah. I might do CrossFit or functional fitness, like, but I'm not a CrossFitter. Like, I think there's a difference. Like, you said you're self-motivated, right? And you could do it by yourself. Shoot, I can't. I can't go to the gym and work out by myself. I can't do it.
Yeah, and that's what's so important for most people too, is it really does. And you have that coach there and stuff, which is huge too. It's like, we have so many people from so many different professions. And I mean, like, think about just your profession. I mean, you know, the schooling you had to go through, the like continuing education, just the knowledge and stuff. It's like, so, and of course yours is a little fitness based, you know, it's definitely like wellness, but think about somebody who does something totally unrelated. Now they've got to come in and think about putting together a decent fitness routine for themselves. Like, they don't want to have to think about that. So it's so nice to be able to kind of come in mindlessly. We have some people that never read. We have a Wattify. You're probably familiar with the software, gym software that puts out our workouts. I did something. Someone asked me to, it's probably been 2 years now, to do like a rundown of the week. And now we do the CrossFit Simplicity, the weekly rundown. We launch it every Sunday. I put it out. It's like a blog post basically about what's coming in the week. Some people don't even look at that. They want to be surprised. But yeah, you said to the person, I'm like, you want me to name him? Because I have to throw him under the bus right now. But like, that's my dad. He's about a little under 60. He'll be 60, I think, maybe this year, maybe the next. You know, not super out of shape, but, you know, and there's always into doing it, but always, if you know, life gets so busy for him, and he's a business owner as well. And so he might have a sabbatical, but always before he comes back, he's like, I'll let you know I'm doing push-ups and air squats at home every night, getting ready to come back. I'm like, oh, what are you doing? You should know better. Like, you don't have to do this. So many times people tell me that. I had another guy the other day, he said, I finally got on the waiting list. I got a rower. We'll start rowing at home for a month or two, and then I'll be ready to come in there. But you know, that's one of the best questions, because I tell people the same thing all the time. I say, hey, listen, you know, we might have fun and get a little competitive in a very healthy environment. And that's not so much in a class environment. It'd more be like two friends in between themselves or something, or pushing each other, motivate each other. And that's a big part of results. But nobody in here, you know, and I'm not going to step on each toes, but, you know, if you're watching this, they know too, right, is going to the CrossFit Games or anywhere near that. So our biggest, like, demographic really is honestly just people trying to lose 10, 15, maybe 30, 40 pounds, you know, just get better health markers, you know, improve their overall fitness. And so I always tell people the best way to do it is just to get in and start. And we did a little special for January. We always had to try to get people in and just – because it's a tough – cost barrier. I want to come off of $145 a month or whatever it may be. Like, you know, that's a big commitment. And so it's always, and I can tell you till I'm blue in the face, hey, listen, you will find this value. We're not competing to be the cheapest gym. We're competing to be the best value. We want you to find that amount of value or more in your membership.
There you go.
But some people are still nervous about taking that step. And so we did a thing, 15 days for $15. Can't beat that. Almost makes me nervous because I'm like, at $15, you're not going to be skin in the game. You might not even show up. But this crew, and they probably won't even – I hope maybe they'll see this. They've been amazing. I mean, they have just been absolutely destroyed. It's like crazy how much they're showing up. But I've had so many conversations in the past week. It's amazing you said that, where I've literally said to people, hey, listen, if you'll just listen to me, I can help you. And our goal should be to almost – trick you into it where you don't even really know you're getting a good workout. At first you go home and you're
okay, I like that.
I really do anything? Like, I don't really know. Rather than people will come in and they'll look around, they'll see what everybody else is doing, and maybe their movement isn't as sexy or isn't as cool, and so or they're not going as fast, and so they'll try to keep up and they'll destroy themselves and they can't come back for a week. And it's like, guys, our goal is to ease you into it so much where before you know it, you're like, hey, I'm getting a little stronger. I feel a little bit better.
Yep.
And if people will take that approach and listen to us as coaches, we're gold. You know, we can keep somebody in here healthy for, you know, years. Excuse me. What happens is people come in, they've been an athlete in the past, or they've been, and so they
try and
like,
go too hard, too fast.
They go too crazy, hard, too fast.
You literally just answered the next question that I was going to ask you, which was, what was the best piece of advice you would give for people that, you know, want to start a health journey or a fitness journey?
Oh yeah, that is it. And I tell you, it's kind of funny. And actually, I sent a little email out this morning to our members, and then I had one of our members that is newer. He's been here for maybe about a month or two. His wife and daughter just started on the 15 days. They're pretty hesitant. Never really done anything like this before, gym stuff in general. And it was so validating, because I always say, and I gave a little spiel before, I said, guys, listen, I don't want to come across as rude or condescending. But then my basic message was like, we've got to like walk, right? Or crawl even before we walk or before we run. And if you'll build this foundation with me, mm-hmm. if you won't look around what else is going on in the class, you'll just build this foundation, then we will be set to like run and we'll do this thing. And he actually texted me today and said, hey, it wasn't condescending. I love the approach. I've been here for a month, but I still want to hear if I'm not doing something right. And so
sure.
that's the biggest thing is my grandparents just moved from Missouri. My grandpa's 79 and trying to get him to come in. I said, hey, look, we will row very slow, 1,000 meters. Every 250 meters, you get off and do 10 gentle ring rows and do 10 push-ups on a box or 10 double dumbbell. I mean, we will walk into this thing.
Now, so if he's from Missouri,
anybody.
If he's from Missouri, was he a farmer?
No, he wasn't actually. Yeah,
I was going to say, because every farmer that I know is stronger and more in shape, regardless of age, 70s, 80s, are still in better shape than the average 30-year-old that I know.
Now, he is good. I don't want to get too COVID, but he actually had COVID about a month ago. Did really great. Yeah, grandma both. They said it was a blessing. But yeah, that's the thing. And I realize it is intimidating. And we try to do everything around here to like not make it intimidating. I mean, it's funny, simple stuff is like the color green is supposed to be a mood or, you know, we were like, let's not go all black and all like hardcore and all, you know, heavy metal.
Right.
Still, at the end of the day, I'll even ask people and still they'll say like, oh no, coming in, I was nervous. But I sent out an email to the 15 days people. And the biggest thing I told them was like, guys, please remember that everybody that's walked through this facility and is in here right now, at one time, they kind of took that leap of faith. They walked through the door. They were brand new. They were nervous. And so, whereas you'll, and I'm not knocking a Globo gym environment at all. Some mm-hmm. people, it's great. But whereas sometimes you'll have an environment in there where people have been there for a really long time and they're really fit, and there's kind of a turnoff to new people, you know, kind of a condescending. It can be.
Yeah.
Not always at all. And some people are the opposite. They're really helpful. And a lot of time it's personality. But a place like this cultivates a personality where when somebody like walks in, everybody is like, oh man, I've been there. You know, oh hey, you're gonna hate you're gonna hate these thrusters today, but you're gonna get through it. You know, and so it's like
right.
So it's, you know, it, for me, it is you know, I don't, you know what the kind of like future holds and stuff, but I know like CrossFit Simplicity, our 5-year, 10-year, 15-year plan is definitely to be here for people, to have this environment, whether it's me coaching every class or somebody else, but you know, to like to be doing that, because I do think it definitely serves, you know, at least our portion of the community. Yep. And people find it. And for the people who find it and love it, it can be, you know, really life-changing as far as the relationships.
Daniel, that's awesome. Thank you so much for what you do. Daniel, if people want to learn more, where can they learn more? How can they reach you?
Yeah, definitely. So just our website is great. You can just Google CrossFit Simplicity or CrossFitSimplicity.com is our website.
Okay.
I am all over there. Our Instagram, just at CrossFit Simplicity. Facebook, same thing. Search CrossFit Simplicity. We're all over there. I think, like I said, Google is a great option. It's great to kind of read what people are saying.
You've got a simple name for the business. So CrossFit Simplicity should not be hard to find. Yeah,
that's right. It's not hard to find. And then my email and stuff is on there all over the place. Perfect. And so we love to have people kind of reach out to us with any kind of questions and stuff. We're always open to that. So
awesome.
We enjoy it.
All right, Daniel, thank you so much. I appreciate it. Thank you.
Yeah, thank you so much. I appreciate it.
All right. Bye-bye, bud.
See ya.